Like any other animate or inanimate creation, ships also have a certain lifespan. Some ships land up in Alang on the Bhavnagar coast, along the western state of Gujarat in India, once they have come to the end of their useful lives. This is a place also known as the graveyard of ships. As part of a series of international negotiations, buyers figure out their proximity to the nearest ship-breaking yard and also the price that they are being offered. Alang's competitors include Chittagong Ship Breaking Yard in Bangladesh, some operations in China and Gadani in Pakistan. Aging ships sail to their final journey to the location where they are pulled apart and their components sold locally as scrap. Alang is the largest ship graveyard in the world. Here, huge oil tankers and cruise liners alike are scrapped on the shorefront by teams of laborers using little more than the most basic hand tools. Piece by piece, workers dismantle the ships that are too old to maintain on the high seas. Seawise Giant, the longest ship ever built, was dismantled here in December 2009. Exxon Valdez, the infamous ship that spilled oil into the Prince William Sound in the Gulf of Alaska, was also killed off at Alang. 11 million gallons of crude oil spilled from the Exxon Valdez into the waters of Alaska. Indian environmental groups claimed that the ship contained asbestos and polychlorinated biphenyls, and the matter went into litigation. But finally, the ship was cleared for destruction in India. Once a ship arrives at Alang, the crew abandon it and fly back, and it is a poignant moment, for the ship will never have another crew. It will never set sail again. The present resting place will be its last, and all that will remain thereafter is its ignominious past and tons of waste steel. The yards of Alang are located on the western coast along the Gulf of Khambat or Cambay, near Alang Sosiai village and 50 kilometers southeast of Bhavnagar on the Veraval State Highway. The first ship was dismantled here in 1983 when its beachfront location was found to be ideal for ship breaking. The tides are heavy here, and the natural slope of the beach makes it easy for a ship to be run onto the shore. The waters are deep and port-like. Most importantly, Alang supplies the ship-breaking industry with an abundant source of labor that is willing to work for low wages. Alang has 10 kilometers of coastline where ship-breaking is done in 163 ship recycling yards, and 60% of the world's retired ships are dismantled here. There are 10 ship recycling yards for VLCC, or very large crude carriers, each having an area of 5,800 square meters. These all feature ships that once sailed the high seas, but are now past their primes and have thus ended up on the shores of Alang. If ships were anthropomorphic, they would probably shudder at the thought of Alang. Such shipbreaking work can only be carried out in nations where there's easy availability of cheap labor and fewer and less stringent restrictions in terms of dealing with hazardous substances. India runs the risk of being labeled as one such liberal destination. But the courts have ensured a modicum of liability and accountability, with administrative responsibility being handed to the Gujarat Maritime Board, essentially a Gujarat state government body. In an average year, Alang recycles around 500 ships and utilizes about 200,000 workers. The Indian recycling industry is valued at 7,000 crore rupees, or around $1 billion. Out of the 170 functional yards at Alang, at least 100 have the ISO 9001, 14001, 18001, and around 50 yards hold the fourth additional certification of ISO 30000. With these ISO certifications for quality control, Indian yards claim to be capable of green ship recycling. The Gujarat Maritime Board has invested heavily to create facilities for the safe disposal of hazardous waste materials generated from recycling activities. Of course, the odd ship yields some prize items. While the shipbreaking yard of Alang contributes ship scrap to the automobile and other indigenous industries, it also gives employment to hundreds of thousands of people and ensures that most of the components of these gigantic human creations live on way after they have ended their seafaring lives. Few romanticize about the emotions associated with the end of the life of a ship. But Wild Films India thought it appropriate to bring you this story of a commercial enterprise that runs entirely on human endeavor, commitment, and emotion.